G'day everyone, Rate Zero AU, and welcome back to another episode of Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. And we are working our way through Surtt's area. Got a fire. And we're going to head up through there. So we've got this sacrifice thing, totem. Let's see how we go. Oh. Go, girl, go. Keep going. She's on fire. Keep running. My. Surely not. What is going on?
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. This darkness takes everything. Everyone.
Senua. Are you sure you want to do this? We can fight this together. Side by side. We always do.
This is my battle. I have to face it alone. Away from here.
Where will you go?
I don't know.
For how long?
I don't know.
I believe in you. You know that. Just promise me that you will come back to me. I want you to say it. You to say it.
I will come back to you. I promise.
Come on.
Oh. This is not going to be good.
You destroyed everything, everyone, but not me. Fight me now.
Come on. Come on. That hurts. Come on.
The surge is getting stronger.
go! Come on. Come on. That's it. Oh. Get away from the fire. Get up. Get him. Hit him. That's it. Whew.
For every battle won, a greater battle takes its place. But so it goes until we fall. And in the end, we all fall. Even the gods have their time. Yet we still go on. Why?
I made a promise. And I will go to hell to keep it.
I die free, knowing you will carry my stories with you. I have fulfilled my quest.
Yes, you have.
When the darkness comes, I vow to guide you in this life and the next to fulfill yours.
Then I will see you in hell.
Be ready to face horror in the eye, as I have, to find your answers. Your quest. The truth.
Whew. All right, so that's it dealt with.
Druth was a troubled man. A scholar turned slave. They tortured him. Took him with them on their raids. Drove him to madness. Spreading this new form of darkness to new worlds. To my world.
Alright, so we gotta head back now. Alright, we did that one. So it's back across here. That should have unlocked that first door we came across. Imagine we're gonna have to fight something along the way. They're not gonna let us just go through like this, are they? Surely not. Oops, went up the wrong one. Now we even got in here. We've somehow got to find our way out. Well, hello. Didn't spot you before.
We see as a rainbow is the bridge that goes from the world of men to the world of the gods. For now, they say the frost giants and the mountain giants cannot cross it. But they say that when Ragnarok comes, not a thing in this world will be safe. The Rainbow Bridge will break under the onslaught of the fire giants riding on flaming steeds. Senua, I have seen the fire of Surt spread far and wide, and to our lands. Ragnarok is coming.
Ragnarok. It's in here, is it? Nope. Completely forgotten which way we came in. Well, it must be around here then, mustn't it? Back up there. If I remember rightly, we saw that before we actually came down. Get up this way, yep. So it's up here. We beat that one? No.
The Northmen say that the defender of Muspel is called Surt, the foremost of the fire giants. His name means the Black One, because he is like something burnt. The Northmen believe that he sits at the border of Muspel with his flaming sword, and at the end of the world he will leave his post. He will travel to Asgard and Midgard, waging war against all the gods. He will be victorious, and then burn the whole world with fire.
Senua saw a deep connection form between the Northmen and darkness. If his tales of hell were true, then that was the source of it. She learned everything she could from him, until she too could see. What he saw.
Well, this isn't good. It's never good when this happens. I don't need to focus on it. I
question. When the illusion of self is shattered, you simply cease to be. Though it may not seem that way to others, you know when it is true. You can feel it. A stranger in your own body. An imposter. And nothing is the same ever again. Senua has died before. And she will do so again. You can be sure of that.
With the mark of Valravn and the mark of Surt, you may cross the bridge over the River of Knives to Helheim.
All right, let's go.
Why is she waiting?
She can't open the gate.
No, it's dangerous. It's dangerous. Don't open the gate.
Darkness.
Don't.
She's done it.
No.
So dark, it's dark, the dark.
Only the dead may cross.
Only the dead may cross.
Only the dead may cross.
Still beats her heart.
Wow. Well, that's pretty powerful.
The darkness touched you. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender, abandon, and find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
Whew. All right. So we're heading over. Come on, then. Talk me, will ya? Nothing to fear anymore. Hello? Than that. Just
it now.
There we go.
Every gate you open into darkness brings another change.
Oh, ow, what was that? No, that's not fair. Get up, girl. Come on. Get up. Back off, back off. Come on. Who's coming? Ow. Come on then, come on. Come on.
Oh,
I was slow on that one. That's it. All right. So we've got a few things to find.
Find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hel to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess.
So we're gonna find an axe. That's right. That one's not right. That one's okay, but we need something to match it up with. Open that door. Right, so the X is here somewhere. Not there, is it? I thought an axe would be so hard to find. Oh, hang on. There it is. There. Right there. Did we unlock it? No. There it is. Alright. That one's actually there as well, but it's backwards. Hang on. Just there. Surely that's it. We have to look from this side, maybe. So there's that one there. Is there a way of getting up? Must be a way of getting up onto this top level, surely. So I reckon that's what we need. We need to get up there. I'm wondering whether it's through this door. Hang on a minute. Oh, there it is. We can't get through this door. Is there any way up there? How do we get upstairs? Unless it's outside this door. Can we go back out this door? No. We have to be able to get upstairs somehow. But how? That dumb. I don't understand. Saying focus. The muscle. Oh. Unbelievable. Alright, so that's what that did. You've got to focus up there, and that gives you the stairs. Up to this level. Yeah. Around this side, or if it's around this side, well, Right, that gives us the S. That just leaves me with that one, which is around this side. Yep, gonna go up here though. Yep. There we go. Okay, so that unlocks all of those. And I reckon if we go down here, we should be able to unlock that door. Yep. And there's a stone here.
Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sick bed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize, half black and half the color of flesh. And her face, menacing and grim.
All right, we'll head through this door. Waiting for it to do a save. Here we go. All right, guys. Going to call the episode here. So I hope you've enjoyed what you've watched. If you have, please leave a like and subscribe. I look forward to seeing you all next time. I'm Raid Zero AU, signing out.